instruments and learning how to use them. And then your encore works a lot of magic with these songs. So I know you all look forward to those fifth graders performing that. And then our chorus will be up right after that. But welcome to our voice.
Hello.
Hello.
Okay, I'm going to turn it over to the kids. They're much better than I am. So, without further ado, I'm going to turn it over to Mr. Osborne, our amazing orchestra teacher for our fifth graders.
Thank you all very much. I am Mr. Osborne, and I have had the privilege of teaching these young fifth grade orchestra students this year. For them, almost every one of them, they had just started their instruments at the beginning of this year. So I know there's a lot of chorus parents in the audience that don't have an orchestra student. So it's just amazing to me that, you know, at the beginning we start out and they really know nothing about the instrument. Very few of them have read music before, unless they've maybe had piano lessons or something. And then we learn how to read music. And we learn, first of all, pizzicatoing, which is plucking the string with our finger. And then just in the last month or so, we have learned how to hold the bow and to play sounds with the bow and try not to squeak too much. So we are at that point right now, and we have four songs that we're going to play for you. They are all fairly short songs, but we have been working hard on them and trying to get them all together, and that's always a challenge with a young group also, just getting them all to play together, start and stop together, and they have been doing a great job of it. They are smiles every day when we practice. We get to practice Monday through Thursday for about half an hour each day, and they're always anxious to get in the orchestra class, and they're always kind of sad when it's over, because it's like, man, it's already over, and it goes quick when you're having a good time. So anyways, without further ado, this is the Adams All-Star Orchestra.
Thank you.
you'll join me in this, but and parents and teachers, let's give Mr. Osborne one more big round of applause first. Thank you for everything you do. You did a great job. And let's give our fifth grader orchestra, All-Star Orchestra, another round of applause. Thank you, guys. Those were really nice. Now, they're going to be cleaning up, and I know there's going to be a little bit of a transition period. After they're cleaned up, they're going to bring chairs to the back so that maybe some more people can have some seats. So we'll wait for that transition. I'm going to turn it over to Miss Anion and Miss Lowry.
All right, so orchestra, as soon as you get that cleared away and you're in chorus, would you go join us at the back of the gym, please? So we'll take just a minute here. We're very happy to have you here tonight. Thank you so much. We're very excited to show you what we have been working on since September. And we know you will enjoy it. Here we go.
So you're sitting in the aisle, we're going to have to ask you to stay. No, just kidding. How are you doing?
Good, how are you?
Good to see you.
I didn't realize you were a fire marshal also. I like straight lines. See ya. It's that military thing.
C-Row, please. Today we will sing holiday songs from around the world. Our wish is peace for all people. Our first selection, Ding Dong Merrily on High, is a French tune. We have a wonderful ensemble of fifth graders to accompany this opening piece.
Thank you. we sing a Mexican Spanish lullaby. Listen for the words Duerme de Niño, which means sleep my little one.
Thank you.
enjoy this joyful melody as much as we have enjoyed learning it.
Thank you.
One big round of applause maybe for Miss Annie and Miss Lowry for all their extra hard work. Thank you guys. They do a great job. Parents, I think we need to thank our parents for making sure that we can do this chorus. Thank you guys for making sure that they get home every afternoon and stay late 2 days out of the week. And then let's give our all-star chorus one more big round of applause. And our fifth graders. They do a great job. All right. Apparently,
Miss
Annie wants to say something.
Yes, I do. Yes, thank you, parents, for making the commitment to have your kids here on Tuesdays and Thursdays and picking them up. We really do appreciate your commitment to that. Before we start stacking chairs, I do have a few other things to say. We will have chorus on Thursday. That will be our last chorus time for this semester, and we will not have chorus again until February 16th. Starting next week, we will start rehearsing with our Circle the State with Song students. Those are 12 students that have been selected to sing in a three-county choral festival that will be at the end of January. So I'd like for our 12 to please raise their hand and wave. Those are our 12 that participate. Tuesday and Thursday next week, and then all through January, okay? And then we will start again with chorus in February. I believe it's the 16th. We have several teachers that are here. Thank you, Mrs. Simon and Mrs. Kill, for being here tonight. I think I saw some. Ms. Morgan and Ms. Brock and Ms. Wesley, thank you for being here tonight. We always want to thank Mrs. Thomason for her support of the music program here at Adams, so thank you very much. on either side. They lay sideways in the racks. We hope you have a very, very good